What is the extent of support you think is required for the lower end of the pyramid that you alluded to? Do you think there should be substantial government investment in some kind of a growth stimulus? Because the trade-off is, what should one do with the fiscal deficit? I mean, that's what the budget is about for, at the end of the day. Because we've strayed away from the path of fiscal discipline because of COVID. This year is the, since tax revenues have seen quite a bit of buoyancy, the big question for the finance minister is whether to get back to the path of fiscal discipline or to give it one more year of elbow room and to try and use this money for some kind of a growth stimulus. If you were in her shoes, what would you choose? What would you opt for?
Udon, see, the revenue part has improved, and that the government deserves credit. It's improving. The GST collection has improved, so there is money in hand. What I would do at this point of time, however, is I would not rush for fiscal discipline, simply because the employment situation for the worst off people, for the farmers, for the workers, for small businesses across the board, it's a very, very difficult time. Barring the people who are at the top end for India, it's a very difficult time. So what should the finance ministry do? Right now, don't go gung-ho on controlling fiscal deficit. Let the fiscal deficit, yes, you can't let it go crazy. It'll be difficult to manage. But don't be overzealous about cutting down fiscal deficit. The inflation control, which is the fear if your fiscal deficit is large, leave it largely to the Central Bank. Reserve Bank of India in India, fortunately, is a very professional body. Leave them with the task of inflation management. You worry about creating jobs. So what you need to do is a large part of this expenditure, the deficit will be still moderately high, but the expenditure has to be flawlessly on productive employment creation. For that, part of it is the direct responsibility of the government. But a part of it is also the government should support and help small businesses, the private sector, but the small private sector, who will then create the jobs where these workers will be pulled in. With all this, there is one more thing I may point out is just like infrastructure. Infrastructure, by the way, India has not done too badly. The infrastructural investment has picked up a little bit, but there are two bedrocks for the market economy. The infrastructure, the physical infrastructure, there is some improvement over there, but there is something else which is economists don't often talk about, though nowadays modern economists have begun talking about. Trust in society is a very invisible kind of trait, but it makes a difference. There are cross-country studies showing that the Scandinavian countries do well because they have trust among themselves higher than in other countries. This has nothing to do with a race or a region, because East Asian countries now have trust levels comparable to Scandinavian countries and do well. India, there has been a trust erosion, and there are informal studies showing that trust has gone down, society has become polarized. I don't know who is to blame, but it is for the government to try to pull it all in together and develop trust, because investment depends on many things, but one of them is trust.
The other thing which she would be weighing in terms of options, Kaushik, is this whole thing between investment and consumption stimulation. Because there is one school of thought which is saying that since incomes have suffered so much at the lower end of the spectrum, there needs to be some kind of consumption support, which, I mean, through any means, some direct benefit transfer, taxation policy, etc. Do you think some of our focus should lie with towards consumption, or would you say 100% towards investment and job creation?
No, quite a bit towards consumption you can't avoid, because I feel we are underestimating the suffering of the bottom half of India. All piecemeal data coming in shows that, and there are some global studies now which are showing that poverty in India is increasing more than in other parts. So India's overall growth is hiding the fact that the bottom segment is doing very, very poorly, not to be taken lightly. For that reason, you have to directly support the poor with money, but also with support which makes the small private sector, the small businesses, begin to grow once again so that they absorb some of the labor. Everything can't be done by the government absorbing the labor. So that's the way in which her expenditure ought to be. Support some consumption. Right now, the suffering is far too great not to do that. But yes, also begin to pay attention to production. What you must not do is expenditure, where you create jobs and there is no production meant for consumption. Because that is right now at this point of time, it is a glaring mistake to do that. It is globally visible. It's embarrassing to spend money on things which are not producing consumables, where there is so much suffering right now that is taking place.